The legal counsel of arrested filmmaker Jade Castro files a manifestation questioning the process of his warrantless arrest. According to attorney Chel Diokno, prosecutors failed to first determine if the arrest of Castro and his companions was lawful before offering them to sign a waiver signifying their consent to remain detained while the investigation is ongoing. He also points out the flaws in the claim of the police that Castro was arrested during a hot pursuit. Diokno insists the filmmaker's arrest was illegal.
What happened here was the prosecutor went immediately to step two. And even worse, there was no explanation given to the four, to Jade Castro and his companions, that by signing that paper, they were in fact agreeing to remain under detention while the preliminary investigation was ongoing. I think they should address the issue of detention first before going to the evidence. I think that one of our most important rights is our right to liberty. And it seems that the Philippine National Police and the authorities in general are not giving it the recognition it deserves in this case.
A group of House lawmakers is calling on Vice President Sara Duterte to talk to her family amid a bitter word war between President Marcos and the Dutertes. Now, this comes after former President Rodrigo Duterte called for the secession of Mindanao and accused Marcos of substance abuse. Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte also demanded Marcos's resignation. That appeal was made by so-called young guns, or the young generation of lawmakers, which include Lanao del Sur 1st District Representative Zia Alonto Adyong, La Union 1st District Representative Francisco Paulo Ortega, Zambales 1st District Representative Jefferson Conghun, and Isabela 6th District Representative Faustino D.
Sana isa lang ang hinihingi namin, na sana kausapin din sana ni VP Sara, no, yung kanyang pamilya, no, para suportahan ang ating pangulo, dahil wala namang ibang gusto ang ating pangulo kundi ang kaunlaran at katahimikan ng ating bansa.
They also urged the elder Duterte and former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez to be more circumspect in their statements.
My calling to our leaders, be more circumspect. If we should not use independence or the issue on secession of Mindanao as a political slogan. We should not use that loosely in order to express our dismay politically. Wag natin gamitin ito na political slogan or tirahin because we are frustrated personally or politically sa nakaupong mga leader. Wag po. Kasi it adds insult to the memories of those who are fallen.
The group pushing for a People's Initiative for Charter Change fails to submit to the Senate a list of alleged donors who financially contributed to a 55 million peso pro-charter change ad. Noel Oñate, lead convener of PIRMA, told senators the volunteers and donors all refused to be identified publicly for security and privacy reasons. Oñate claims a controversial TV ad pushed the donors to withdraw their contributions, amounting to 28 million pesos in funding. Oñate's pronouncements irked panel members who insisted the TV ad for charter change was deceptive in encouraging people to sign up for the People's Initiative.
You deceive the public. Suportahan ninyo ang PI para ganito ganon. Tapos ang laman ng pinapapirma ninyo, i-diminis ang power ng Senado. Ha? How deceptive can you be with this kind of approach?
That was not our intention. We know na i-invalidate ng COMELEC ang mga signatures if tainted with irregularity or anomaly yung pag-solicit ng signatures. Ayaw po namin masayang ang lahat ng pinaghirapan.
The group of lawmakers calling for a probe into the deadly landslide in southern Philippines. Davao de Oro Congressman Roel Gonzaga said Tuesday he and his colleagues have filed a resolution urging the lower house to look into the cause of the tragedy in his district. Gonzaga called for accountability over the incident, as he said the site of the landslide in Maco was a no-build zone. The filing of the resolution came as the remains of more victims were recovered today. Officials say the death toll stands at 68, with 50 others still missing. Authorities are now shifting to search and retrieval operations as they admit the chances of finding more survivors are dimming by the day. The prices of some flowers at the famous Dangwa Flower Market have more than doubled on the eve of Valentine's Day. We have more on that story from our correspondent, Jervis Manahan. Jervis?
There is a constant stream of people arriving here in Dangwa, the flower capital of Manila. This is in preparation for tomorrow's Valentine's Day. As expected, the prices of flowers are up. Some have doubled, while some are priced way higher. A stem of sunflower, which used to be sold for 100 pesos, is now at 200 pesos, while a stem of rose is at 150 pesos. Dried flowers, tulips, and Ecuadorian roses are also selling fast. Prices are expected to go higher tonight and even tomorrow. People didn't seem to mind these high prices because they say this happens only once a year and it is an expression of love. Traffic is also getting quite bad, but security is tight and there is a lot of policemen visible in the area. Customers are constantly being reminded to take care against pickpockets. Shops are operating for 24 hours now, so customers can visit even late at night. Ron.
Jervis Manan with that story. Thanks. Meanwhile, an employers group calls as unfortunate the Senate proposal for higher wages. It warns smaller firms will bear the brunt of having to pay their employees more, forcing them to raise their services cost. The group also believes any relief from the wage hike will only be temporary.
We have just every day our inflation going down. And imposing 100 pesos will spiral prices. Those who are able to get this 100 pesos will have temporary enjoyment a bit.
Okay.
But after a few months, the prices will catch up and it will be lost. They're still pushing for that 100 when all the economic managers are saying don't do it. All the economists, even the academicians, I have not heard of anybody except those who are proposing it,